Matrix is just a table of numbers, a two-dimensional array of numbers. So we have to specify in the table, you have rows and columns. So you just have to specify the rows and columns, number of rows and number of columns. So it's usually written as m by n, the row first and column second, always row. So an example matrix here, just some random numbers, but three rows and four columns, okay? So A is a 3x4 matrix. So A is a member of R 3x4. That's the way I read the guy over here. This is R 3x4. It's not R to the power, okay? It's just R 3x4, which is a set of all possible matrices with real elements, three rows and four columns. So that's what it is. It's a set of all possible matrices. So A here is a member of that set. Now let me define scalar multiplication for a matrix. I have a matrix here. I'm multiplying it by a number 3. I'll multiply each element by number 3. Identical to the vector multiplication, I'm just extending it to matrix. If I have two matrices, I can add them. Again, analogous to vector addition, I'm just adding the corresponding elements. The first element here will get added to the first element here. The second element here will get added to the second one. The third element here will get added to the third element there. And that element there will get added to this element here. I would say it is a 1 minus 2, that is here, 2 plus 3, that is here, 3 plus 0, that is here, and 1 plus 7, that is over here. So as you can see, if you want to add two matrices, they have to be of the same number of rows and columns, okay? There's no other way. Nothing else can be added. Matrices will have to match in terms of their dimensions for them to add. Now that we have defined matrices, we can see that vectors are actually just matrices of one column. This is the same as a size n by 1, but we'll drop the 1 and then we'll write it as a Rn. We never write Rn by 1. By 1 is understood. So an n-dimensional vector is actually a matrix of n rows and one column. So matrices and vectors, now we can see that since we defined the scalar multiplication and addition, they obey the same rules. Their rules are not different. So we needn't have defined all these separate set of rules for vectors. We did it just because we motivated the concept of vectors using the linearity. Now, some people might think of rows as vectors too and call it row vectors. I don't like it. So I will stay away from that kind of monstrosities. Our vectors are always going to be column vectors. And if I really want to talk about a row, I'll say a transpose of a column vector. So vectors are just special cases of corresponding matrices. So vector operations are just special cases of the corresponding matrix operations. So dimensions should match in addition. A plus B is defined if and only if the numbers of columns and rows match. In particular, vectors cannot add to matrices and the vectors of different dimensions cannot add. Also, a zero vector in three dimension, R3, is 0, 0, 0. It's not the same as a zero vector in R2. They live in different universes, parallel universes. They never talk to each other. Well, they might talk to each other, but they don't add or scale or anything with each other. In the definitions of our scalar multiplication and addition of matrices or vectors, there is a similarity. There is a correspondence with those and our homogeneity and additivity conditions. Okay, it's not an accident. That's the basis of linear algebra. So let me get a bit formal and list all the different properties of these guys. Scaling, scalar multiplication and addition. They're commutative, order doesn't matter. So you can multiply in any order. So these are the same. They are all consequences of the way we defined these additions and the scalar multiplication. They are also associative, which means you can group them in any order. S1, S2, X is the same as multiplying the scalars first and then scaling the vector, or scaling the vector with one and then the other. And of course you can commute also if you want. Same thing goes with associativity of scalar multiplication of matrices. And for addition also you can group them in any order. These are all fairly straightforward consequences of the definitions of these operations. They are distributive too. So if you scale a sum of two vectors, is the same as scaling the vectors and then summing them up. Same thing goes for matrices too. And then you can write the second way of doing it. You can add two scalars, S1 plus S2. The whole thing multiplying a vector is the same as the first scalar S1 multiplying X plus the second one scaling X. Same thing with matrices. All fairly obvious. Just saying these things for the sake of completeness.